Thanks to UniSA mathematician Professor Peter Pudney, 8,000 trains around the world are now much safer and more efficient. His smart train driver software, Energymiser, has been consistently refined and improved over the past 23 years in collaboration with TTG Technology. The sale of TTG to global giant Modaxo marks the end of UniSA's longest-running industry partnership, but ushers in an exciting new chapter with one of the world's biggest transportation companies.
The aim of the software is to give drivers driving advice that keeps the train on time, but also minimises the amount of energy that's used by the train as it completes its trip. We have data about the track, so the hills and the curves, the speed limits. We have information about the train and also about the timetable. And we look forward at the entire journey and work out what's the best way to drive the train so that we arrive at every location along the route at the correct time and minimise the amount of energy that we use to get there. The technology has changed over the years. When it started, we had just a little box with some light bulbs on it that told the driver, you know, now power now or coast now. Then we had some dedicated hardware that was put in, so a screen that sits in front of the driver. And now a lot of it's being done on tablet devices, and even we can have it running on your phone. And as well as telling the driver how to drive, we can also display information to the driver that gives them situational awareness. So it shows them a picture of the track and where they are on the track and what the speed limits are, the curves and the gradients. So it gives them confidence about where they are on their journey, what's going to happen next, and we give them advice on how to do it efficiently. The technology changes have been enormous. When we started, if we wanted to know where a train was along its trip, we used to count the number of times the wheels went round. But now, of course, we use GPS. I think there's a future ahead for this work to continue. We certainly haven't solved all of the industry's problems yet. The big problem is going to be, firstly, the coordination of many trains to improve systems. We're at the stage now with railways where you can't just build more trains and more track. Railways are becoming congested, and so it's important to control them much more tightly. And there's going to be an ongoing need to reduce the energy use of trains as we move into a sort of carbon-constrained world, and a world where we need to match our energy use to the available supply of renewable energy. So that means that the challenges are going to keep on coming.